सी द फोर्थ प्रॉब्लम, 2 kg ऑफ एयर इज हीटेड एट कॉन्स्टेंट वैल्यूम, द टेम्परेचर ऑफ एयर इज इंक्रीज्ड फ्रॉम 293 केल्विन टू 313 केल्विन, इफ द स्पेसिफिक हीट ऑफ एयर एट कॉन्स्टेंट वैल्यूम इज 0.718 किलोजोल पर केजी पर केल्विन, फाइंड द अमाउंट ऑफ हीट अब्सॉर्ब्ड इन किलोजोल एंड किलो कैलोरी। इन दिस प्रॉब्लम मास ऑफ द एयर इज गिवेन, दैट इज एम इज इक्वल 2 kg एंड द टेम्परेचर ऑफ एयर इज इंक्रीज्ड फ्रॉम, दैट इज T1 इज इक्वल 293 केल्विन टू T2 इज इक्वल 313 केल्विन। सो फ्रॉम दिस टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस, दैट इज dT इज इक्वल T2 माइनस T1, दैट इज इक्वल 313 माइनस 293, दैट इज इक्वल 20 केल्विन। एंड द स्पेसिफिक हीट ऑफ एयर एट कॉन्स्टेंट वैल्यूम इज गिवेन, दैट इज CV इज इक्वल 0.718 किलो जोल पर केजी पर केल्विन। सो हियर किलो इज इक्वल 1000, सो इट कैन बी रिटन एज CV इज इक्वल 1000 इंटू 0.718, दैट इज इक्वल 718 जोल पर केजी पर केल्विन। सो वी नो द अमाउंट ऑफ हीट अब्सॉर्ब्ड, दैट इज QV एट कॉन्स्टेंट वैल्यूम इज इक्वल m इंटू CV इंटू dT। सो हियर m इज 2 केजी, CV इज 718 एंड dT इज 20। सो फ्रॉम दिस वी कैन गेट QV इज इक्वल 28,720 जूल्स। सो इट कैन बी रिटन एज QV इज इक्वल 28.720 किलो जूल्स। सो हियर QV इज इक्वल 28,720 इंटू, हियर 1 जूल इज इक्वल वी नो 4.2 कैलोरी। सो हियर वी कैन गेट 6,838 कैलोरीज। सो फ्रॉम दिस वी कैन गेट Q इज इक्वल 6.838 किलो कैलोरीज। सी द फिफ्थ प्रॉब्लम, ए क्लॉक विथ ए ब्रास पेंडुलम कीप्स करेक्ट टाइम एट 20 degrees Celsius बट लूज 8.212 सेकंड पर डे व्हेन द टेम्परेचर राइजेस टू 30 degrees Celsius। कैलकुलेट द कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ लीनियर एक्सपेंशन ऑफ ब्रास। इन दिस प्रॉब्लम ए ब्रास पेंडुलम शो करेक्ट टाइम एट 20 degrees Celsius। सो एट 20 degrees Celsius θ1 इज इक्वल 20 degrees Celsius, इट शो करेक्ट टाइम, दैट इज टाइम पीरियड ऑफ पेंडुलम इज t1 इज इक्वल 2 seconds बिकॉज इट इज ए सेकंड्स पेंडुलम। एट θ2 इज इक्वल 30 degrees Celsius, दैट इज व्हेन टेम्परेचर rises to 30 degrees Celsius, it lose time 8.212 second per day. We don't know time period of pendulum at 30 degrees Celsius. For simple pendulum, we know T is equal to 2 pi under root of L by G. From this we can write T is equal 2 pi G to the power of 1 by 2 L to the power of 1 by 2. Here I am taking relative error in time period. Del t by t is equal. Here it is 1 by 2. That is 1 by 2 into relative error in length. That is del L by L. So from this, we can write del L by L is equal 2 into del t by t. Let us take this is equation 1. We know gain or loss of time per day is equal. Number of oscillations in one day into change in time for one oscillation. Let us take this is second equation. We know one day is equal 24 hours. Here that is equal 24. 1 hour is equal 60 minutes. So that is equal 24 into 60 into here 1 minute is equal 60 seconds. So finally, one day is equal here we know 86,400 seconds. For seconds pendulum, time taken for one oscillation is 2 seconds. That is, for 2 seconds, number of oscillations is 1 oscillation. So here, for 86,400 seconds, how many oscillations occur? That is, number of oscillations in one day is equal to 86,400 into 1 by 2. So that is equal 43,200. Let us take this is equation third. We know change in time for one oscillation is equal del t. From equation 1, del t can be written as that is equal t by 2 into del L by L. Here t is time period of pendulum. So that is time period of second pendulum is 2 seconds. So here 2 by 2 cancel. So finally it is del L by L. That is change in time per one oscillation is del L by L. Let us take this is fourth equation. Loss of time per day is given. That is equal 8.212 second. Let us take this is equation 5. Substitute equation 3, 4, 5 in equation 2. In equation 2, we can get that is loss of time per day is equal to how much it is 8.212 is equal number of oscillations in one day is equal 43,200 into change in time for one oscillation is del L by L. So from this we can get del L by L is equal 8.212 by 43,200. So that is equal, here it is 0.00019. We know coefficient of linear expansion alpha L is equal del L by L into 1 by del theta. So that is, here alpha L is equal, here del L by L is equal how much? That is 0.0019. So 0.00019 by del theta is equal theta 2 minus theta 1. That is 30 minus 20 degrees Celsius. So from this we can get 0.00019 by 10. So therefore here alpha L is equal 19 into 10 to the power of minus 6 for degree Celsius. See the example problem 12.4. When 0.15 kg of ice of 0 degree Celsius mixed with 0.30 kg of water at 50 degree Celsius in a container, the resulting temperature is 6.7 degree Celsius. Calculate the heat of fusion of ice. Here 0.15 kg of ice of 0 degree Celsius. So that is, ice is at 0 degree Celsius is mixed with 0.30 kg of water at 50 degree Celsius. So here it is a hot body, here it is a cold body. So by the principle of calorimetry, heat lost by the hot body is equal to heat gained by the cold body. So here heat lost by the hot body is used to change its phase, that is ice at 0 degree Celsius to water at 0 degree Celsius. So the final temperature is 6.7 degree Celsius. Here there is no phase change. So heat lost by the hot body is equal to M S del T. Here ice is at 0 degree Celsius is converted into water at 0 degree Celsius. So the required heat is M L F. But here there is no phase change. Here it is water and here also it is water. So the required heat is M S del theta. Here heat lost by water is equal M1 SW, here theta F minus theta I. So that is equal, here mass of the water is 0.30 kg and specific heat capacity of water is 4186 joule per kg per Kelvin. Here theta F is equal 50 minus 6.7. So from this we can get 54,376.14 joule. Heat required to melt ice So that is M2LF. Here mass of the ice is 0.15 kg. Here we have to find LF value. That is LF. Heat required to increase 0 degree Celsius water to 6.7 degree Celsius. So that is M S delta T. So that is theta F minus theta I. So here SW. Mass of the ice is 0.15 kg and SW, specific heat of water, is 4186 joule per kg per Kelvin into theta F 6.7 minus 0. So that is, here we can get 4206.93 joule. By the principle of calorimetry, heat lost by the hot body is equal to heat gained by the cold body. So here heat lost is 54,376.14 joule. That is equal to heat gained by the cold body. So that is 0.15 into LF plus 4206.93 joules. From this we can get LF is equal 3.34 into 10 to 4 of 5 joule per kg. See the example problem 12.5. Calculate the heat required to convert 3 kg of ice at minus 12 degrees Celsius kept in a calorimeter to steam at 100 degrees Celsius at atmospheric pressure. Given specific heat capacity of ice is 2100 joule per kg per Kelvin. Specific heat capacity of water is 4186 joule per kg per Kelvin. Latent heat of fusion of ice is 3.35 into 10 to 4 of 5 joule per kg, and latent heat of steam is 2.256 into 10 to 4 of 6 joule per kg. Here 3 kg of ice at minus 12 degrees Celsius. First, convert into ice at 0 degree Celsius. Here, there is no phase change. It is ice. Here also, it is ice. So, the required heat is, let us take Q1 is equal to Ms delta T. Then, ice at 0 degree Celsius is converted into water at 0 degree Celsius. Here it is a phase change. So required heat is, that is Q2 is equal to MLF. Then water at 0 degree Celsius is converted into water at 100 degree Celsius. So here there is no phase change. So required heat is Q3 is equal to MS del theta. Then water at 100 degrees Celsius is converted into steam at 100 degrees Celsius. So here it is a phase change. Required heat is Q4 is equal to MLV. So ice at minus 12 degrees Celsius is converted into steam at 100 degrees Celsius. Required heat is Q is equal, we can write Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4. Mass of the ice is given, that is called M is equal 3 kg. Specific heat capacity of ice is given, so that is 2100 joule per kg per Kelvin. Specific heat capacity of water is given, so that is 4186 joule per kg per Kelvin. Latent heat of fusion of ice is given, that is LF ice is equal 3.35 into 10 to 4 of 5 joule per kg. Latent heat of steam is given, that is L steam is equal 2.256 into 10 to 4 of 6 joule per kg. So let us find Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. Here Q1 is equal heat required to convert high set minus 12 degree Celsius to high set 0 degree Celsius. That is M S ice del theta. So that is equal, here mass of the ice is 3 kg into specific heat of ice is 2100 joule per kg per Kelvin into here theta 2 minus theta 1, that is minus 12 minus 0 degree Celsius. So from this we can get Q1 is equal 75,600 joules. Here Q2 is equal heat required to melt ice at 0 degree Celsius to water at 0 degree Celsius. That is M LF ice. So that is equal 3 kg into LF ice is given, that is 3.35 into 10 to the power of 5 joule per kg. Here it is 10,05,000 joules. Next, Q3 is equal heat required to convert water at 0 degree Celsius to water at 100 degree Celsius. That is MSW del theta. So that is called M is 3 kg. Here SW is equal 4186 joule per kg per Kelvin into del theta. That is 100 minus 0 degree Celsius. That is 100. So here we can get joules. Next one is Q4. Heat required to convert water at 100 degree Celsius to steam at 100 degree Celsius. That is ML steam. So here M is 3 kg. L steam is 2.256 into 10 to 4 of 6 joule per kg. So from this here we can get 67,68,000 joules. Therefore Q is equal Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4. Here Q1 is equal 75,600 joules plus Q2 is equal 10,05,000 joules plus Q3 is equal 12,55,800 joules plus Q4 is equal 67,68,000. Finally, we can get Q is equal 9.1 into 10 to the power of 6 joules.